Plants evolved from algae around 450 million years ago. But before we could have all the amazing diversity that we can see outside, a lot of things had to change. So plants adapted to life on land using multiple strategies. And one of them was to recruit a group of fungi called arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi. Mycorrhizal fungi are better suited to gather nutrients. And in exchange for these scant nutrients, plants will deliver food that they produce and that fungi cannot get produced by themselves. This deal, this trading deal that is so ancient, was so successful that it was written in the most essential component of life, which is the DNA. The DNA is like a manual that has all the instructions, which we call genes, that are required to build and to control an organism. My project is aimed at understanding how plants and fungi cooperate to succeed. And I do this by studying the instructions that are regulating this trade deal between plants and fungi. My approach was first to identify those instructions that are relevant for the mycorrhizal deal. And we did this by comparing the manuals of 40 plant species that still honor this deal with the manuals of 10 plant species that kind of opted out of this deal. Because in this case, those plants that didn't follow the deal, they don't require these instructions anymore. So over time, they lost these instructions. So our prediction was that then those instructions that were lost in non-trading plants were the ones that were required for this trade deal. To test whether this was the case, we amended some of those instructions in the manuals of some of the trading plants, just like the White House is now doing with the NAFTA deal, for example. Unlike Canada and Mexico, however, mycorrhizal fungi didn't like it. So when we analyzed the plants that had the amended instructions, we realized that the trade deal between fungi and plants was called off, and thus confirming our hypothesis that these instructions are really required for this trade deal. By using this approach, we are gaining an insight into what it takes for two very different organisms to cooperate. And so far, we have learned a few things. For instance, we have learned that plants have a special instruction to produce an excess of fats that they then use to feed the fungus. Mycorrhizal fungi cannot produce their own fats and then rely on the plant for this food. And by using this knowledge to try to grow mycorrhizal fungi, to increase the growth of mycorrhizal fungi in the lab so that it can be used in agriculture. And by having this knowledge, I think we can manage the deal between fungi and plants in a way in which fungi will help us grow more food. Thank you.